Straight down in Southeast Kansas, in a town of Coffeyville, on October 5th of 1892. All was quiet and serene, till a gang came on the scene, on that peaceful sunny day in 92. And so it was that the small band of desperadoes embarked on one of the most dastardly escapades involving civilized people in frontier American history. Scores and scores of years have gone by since the Dalton brothers conducted their raids on the two Coffeyville banks, yet the legend lives on, and interest increases with each passing year. This old jail is the original identical building that was used in the Dalton shootout in 1892. Since that date, it's been modified some, as it's been used for a variety of purposes. But the building where you are right now is the original structure. Because several members of the Dalton gang were shot down in the alley right here by the jail building, this section of the passageway has since been known by local citizens as Death Alley. The site nearby, occupied by H.W. Reach Department Store, at that time was the location of John Clare's livery barn. It had a solid board fence at the rear. This board fence was the backdrop for the stage, where the battle between the desperados and the local defenders was joined. It was in this area also that the dead members of the gang were laid out for the camera of Coffeyville's photographer, John Tackett. This famous picture may be seen in a massive blow-up and is available in postcard form at the Dalton Museum. The museum is just a block and a half east from here on 8th Street. When the Dalton gang rode into Coffeyville that October day in 1892, its members planned to tie their horses to the hitching posts on the east side of the Condon Bank building. This would have placed their horses between the two bank buildings where they planned to commit their daring daylight holdup and had their horses readily accessible for an instant getaway. However, when they arrived in downtown Coffeyville, they found improvement work being done on Union Street between the banks, and the hitching posts had been removed. The gang had to change plans on the spot and tie their horses west of Walnut Street in the alley just to the east of the jail building. Had the horses been tied closer to the banks, the outcome of the raid would have probably been different. The Dalton gang consisted of three Dalton brothers, Bob, Grant, and Emmett, plus Dick Rodwell and Bill Powers. During the bloody shootout, Bob and Grant Dalton and Bill Powers all fell dead in the alley right here. Dick Rodwell, mortally wounded and with blood gushing from his mouth, mounted his horse and galloped out of town. His body was found 2 miles away, and his riderless horse was recovered in Indian Territory. Emmett, the youngest of the Dalton brothers, was unwounded through the heaviest part of the gun battle, and with almost $25,000 in cash on his person, Emmett leaped upon his horse, a swift racer, and headed for the end of the alley and almost certain freedom. But before reaching the entrance of the alley, he pulled up his racehorse, reined it around, and rode back into a hail of bullets from the city's defenders. Emmett tried to lift his brother Bob, who was already dead, that he might carry his body with him when he escaped. It was at this moment the local defenders fired a load of buckshot into Emmett's back, and the youngest Dalton fell unconscious at the sight of his brother, with a shattered arm, a broken thigh, and a back full of buckshot. And so ended the last raid of Dalton's. In Death Alley lay three dead raiders, another badly wounded, and the fourth was dead 2 miles out in the country. Four Coffeyville citizens also died in the fray. At least an equal number suffered gunshot wounds. Dead and dying horses, smoking Winchesters, and distracted citizens added to the whole. Guards were quickly placed, the dead and wounded defenders were removed to their homes, and the bodies of the dead raiders were placed in the jail. Emmett Dalton, the sole gang member to survive, found refuge in the office of Dr. Walter Wells. Coffeyville went into mourning for the heroic men who had given their lives for the protection of fellow citizens and the maintenance of law and order in their hometown. This old jail and the adjacent Death Alley will continue as memorials to the local citizens who sacrificed their lives in the Dalton's last raid.
Yes, it's true, the Dalton had had you all the night. They were near to Fortune's door, they knew. And they left their horses tied by the
Christmas tree.